PR Plus presents a video by Parvati Gopakumar, she/her, a law student and a nemophilist who talks about the impact her amputation had on her mental health and emotional well-being.
Hi everyone, I am Parvati Gopakumar. I am a disabled person and I became a disabled person when my right hand was amputated following an accident in 2010 when I was just 12 years old. I am a natural righty and I had to learn to do everything with my left hand from that day onwards. It was a completely new life for me as I had literally no clue as to what to expect in this new life. I had to unlearn so many things I learned till then and then learn everything from the scratch. For example, I had to learn to write with my left hand and I couldn't compromise on this because I was still in school and had many years of schooling left. So for me, this was a priority. So initially, most of my energy was spent on acquiring those necessary life skills that would help me survive this new life. As I was a kid, everyone around me were trying to keep me happy and they talked about how blessed I am and how privileged I am and how I should be happy for whatever I've got. I did receive counseling sessions in the hospital itself, but I faked that I was okay. I couldn't communicate my inhibitions and problems with the doctor because I was scared that she might share it with my parents and that would be harsh on them. So I pretended to be happy and confident and people around me were actually complimenting me for taking my disability so lightly that my parents aren't stressed. So I came to this conclusion that my parents' happiness solely depended on how I tackle things. Now this was a huge responsibility for a teenage child. I was hell-bent on faking all the happiness and confidence because I didn't want anyone, especially my parents, to know what I was going through. I was really hard on myself. I didn't accept the disabled version of me and I kept denying it to myself. Now, living in denial is very tricky, especially for a child. I was not proud or even okay with my disability, but I was being identified and recognized for that very thing everywhere I went. This is when I tried to assert myself as something I was not. I tried to bully my school juniors, was racist, homophobic, and really into gossip. And I tried to please and be friends with literally every single person. I am an introvert, but I push myself to be this really outgoing person who does everything. All of this while I was constantly comparing myself to others. I remember taking great pride in not crying in front of others, although I used to have these terrible breakdowns when I was alone or in the washrooms or something. High school is hard for everyone, but it was harder for me because I was figuring out this new life while hating myself. There is this dialogue about adjusting to a new life physically when you have acquired a disability, but mental health is equally important. It took me almost 6 years to accept me for who I am, and that is when I stopped faking my emotions. So initially, all my energy was spent on proving this point to others that I'm okay and happy. And this was because I wanted people to see me for who I am, keeping my disability aside. But the more I tried to consciously do that, the more unhappy and anxious I was. I did try to get help, but some of the insensitive people around me, like some of the teachers, etc., cancelled my emotions, saying that I was just another attention seeker. I didn't know how to put my emotions into words then. I knew how to ask for help, so I tried to do that indirectly. I had a lot of rage and frustration that I didn't know what to do with. The more people tried to put me in a box, the more I tried to push myself out of it. It was only when I took arts and joined a new school that I figured that I was going to be okay. This new school was a new opportunity for me to start afresh because people there didn't have any preconceived notions about me. As I did well in academics and extracurricular activities, my confidence gradually grew and I began to love myself. I could see myself as this any other girl and not as this girl to whom terrible things have happened in the past. This is when I made a conscious effort to stop doing all the negative things I used to do till then. Now I won't fake happiness or confidence or any other thing just so that people can have a certain perception of me. And I'm really proud of my ability to be vulnerable. I'm so proud of myself for growing so much and for being a person that I'm really, really proud of. And as a last minor flex, I love myself.
This video ends with two logos on a yellow background. The first one is a pink heart and a plus sign and has PR plus written underneath. And the second one is a green and black eye and has point of view written next to it.